gorgeous San Diego, California, where the sun sets on another evening and on another regular season of college football. Here inside SDCCU Stadium, the season finale of the regular season for the San Diego State Aztecs, a mark of 7-4, and the Hawaii Rainbow Warriors, who come to town with a record of 7-5. It's ESPN College Football, and it's presented to you by Dr. Pepper. A crucial matchup for these two teams to try and bolster their resumes for bowl committees looking forward to the postseason. They're 2 of 7 bowl eligible teams, Wyoming joining that group today, and a crucial matchup going on right now on ESPN to determine the champion of the Mountain West Conference's Mountain Division, with Boise State hosting Utah State, 10-1, one of the highest scoring teams in the country. Hawaii hoping to break a little bit of historical precedent. They've had a rough go of it against these Aztecs, and as of late, it's been quite lopsided scoring-wise as well, with the Aztecs winning 6 straight by an average score of 35-11. And the Rainbow Warriors' last win of the series coming back in 2005. Rocky Long, head coach of San Diego State, Nick Rolovich at the helm for Hawaii. They win the toss and they elect to kick, so San Diego State will open with the ball. There goes Juwan Washington out across the 20 with a burst of speed, 30, and tumbling forward to the 40-yard line. Nice starting field position tonight for the Aztecs in pursuit of win number 8. Welcome to San Diego, just underway between Hawaii at 7-5 and San Diego State 7-4, the regular season finale for these two teams. Mike Cousin with the San Diego State Hall of Famer, 2-time All-American linebacker here for the Aztecs, Kirk Morrison. Glad you're joining us here on what is a lovely evening. On his senior night, one of 14 seniors, Christian Chapman gets the start at quarterback and hands it off to Chase Jasmine. No pickup on first down. Kirk, that's going to be a key for them tonight under Rocky Long. Now in his 8th season, running the ball well means winning games, and they haven't done that the last couple weeks.
Very unlike a Rocky Long football team. The last 2 football games, they have not ran the ball well. And if San Diego State does not run the ball well, you've seen the outcome. They lose football games. Tonight is imperative that they get the running game going, especially as they try to get these 2 quarterbacks situated into this football game.
Chapman with play action. And he scrambles forward about a 1/2 yard shy of the first down marker at the initial spot for the senior from Carlsbad, California, who's been hurt this year, played in 5 of the team's 11 games, but has started the last 2 weeks, battled through an MCL sprain earlier this year, and is the school's winningest quarterback in the program's history.
Yeah, you can think about Christian Chapman and what he brings to this offense. He brings consistency, but he's been out for the most of the season, and that's probably one of the reasons why San Diego State's had so many woes offensively.
So 3rd and very short, and that play is disrupted. Washington in the backfield is crushed by Cheyenne Sanatoa, the sophomore linebacker who turns away the Aztecs to send it to 4th down.
You got to get a hat on the hat, Mike, and if you don't do that, it's guys like Sanatoa who come through the offensive line and just finds a space. Just watch 41. I was always taught, you see space, you run space, and that's what Sanatoa does. He just goes, finds the ball carrier, unaccounted for, unblocked. Terrific start defensively for Hawaii.
Eichlund's punt takes a bounce inside the 20-yard line, and that's where Hawaii gets set to take over and start the game offensively. A sharp offensive attack averaging more than 30 points a game, and they've had a little bit of turnover at quarterback, injury related, with Cole McDonald giving way to Chevin Cordero.
Right.
Injury, but Cordero has been great. Don't expect to see him tonight, though, considering that he's got 3 games,
right,
and McDonald has been the starter and earned that position.
Well, it's the redshirt rule, and he's played 3 games already. Do you worry about saving him for the bowl game and you're still trying to figure out, look, do you even get into a bowl this season? So it's a lot of decisions for Coach Rolovich.
Fred Holley, the running back in the backfield, along with McDonald, who no surprise is back to throw. And he hits it right near the sticks for the completion. Now, McDonald started 11 of the 12 games, only missed the Wyoming game due to injury this year, and best in the Mountain West with 32 touchdowns and sixth in all of college football with his passing yards at over 3,300.
He's also rushed for over 373 yards as well, so not only he's active in space in creating plays, but we know how lethal his arm can be.
Second and short, enough of a push for Holley, the sophomore from Riverside, California, with his 95th carry of the year to get the first down.
This is a big drive for McDonald. I know it's just the first drive of the game, but look, he's the starter today. And he's not looking over his shoulder at Chevin Cordero, who came in last week and really rallied this Hawaii team to a fourth quarter comeback over UNLV. This is about him right now, McDonald, settling into this football game and getting back to what we saw for most of the season.
Spreading it out five wide, the Hawaii offense averaging almost 430 yards a game, a top 50 number in the country. Pressure comes, a lob down the sideline, that pass is caught and deep into Aztec territory. Huge pickup for Hawaii.
Well, look, just watch the quarterback. He knows he's going to get hit, but watch him stand in there in the pocket. He delivers the football to Jason Matthew Sharsh, and he's just wide open. Just no one is there around. A San Diego State defender nowhere near, but you got to have toughness at the quarterback position. That's what McDonald brings. He knew he was going to get hit, but he stood in there, delivered that football, and that was a bust in the coverage for San Diego State.
McDonald to Sharsh goes for 49, Kirk. Ursua cuts across the middle. First down and then some, taking it to the 10-yard line. Well, Hawaii's moving, Kirk, and when they've got the ball, what are your keys?
My keys are handling the chaos at San Diego State's defense, the 3-3-5. They're going to blitz, but then also Johnny on the spot. That's John Ursua. He just caught the last pass. They got to get the football to him early and often. San Diego State defensive, they got to shake off that rust for the last couple weeks, and they need to phone a friend. Communication, which we've already seen right now, not communicating in the back end, already with the big play to Sharsh.
Rush up the middle, and McDonald goes down. Pressure comes from Kiava Tuzino. We saw perhaps the best defensive effort of the year from him against Boise State, and that was the key to success, a burst through the middle for a sack.
Well, you're looking at an all-conference linebacker, and then when they come out with the honors in the next couple weeks, number 44 for San Diego State, he better be in the first team, maybe even defensive player of the year. The way that he's played, that nice little spin move to the inside, 7.5 sacks now for Kiava Tuzino, who has really become the best player on this Aztec defense this season.
Middle linebacker, he's racked up second most quarterback pressures in all of college football. The inside toss goes to Miles Reed, the freshman, after they lost 7 on the sack. They get it back and then some, just on the doorstep of scoring the game's first points.
Well, I'll tell you this, this should be for four down territory regardless. So what happens here on third down, if I'm Coach Rolovich of Hawaii, I'm calling two plays. It's the first play here, third down, and then if I don't get it, I'm going to go for it on fourth down. It's a nice little drive that you've got going with some big plays. Keep putting pressure on this Aztec defense. This is two plays down here, right here at the 5.
Look out for Ursua in the slot to the bottom of the screen. Only a look to the left. The ball is tipped and incomplete. Intended for Cedric Bird. McDonald looking for his roommate in the end zone, and it's fourth and goal. Here comes special teams.
Yeah, they're going to bring out the field goal unit. I like the play design. I just didn't like the throw. That throw has to be a little bit lower. That throw ball has to be on the wide receiver, Bird. That ball is just a little bit too high, forcing the field goal.
So it's Ryan Mesko, the junior from Australia, for the try. And his kick is good. 3-0 Hawaii. Big drive to start for McDonald. 4 of 5 through the air, but came up empty on the last one. Rainbow Warriors with a field goal. Welcome back to ESPN College Football, presented by Dr. Pepper. This is where Kirk Morrison says he spent most of his time in college at San Diego State, on the beach.
That is the motto, Mike, by the way. You vacation where I live.
Here comes Juwan Washington. That was like the high school motto for cross country. Our sport is every other sport's punishment. Play fake, looking to go deep here to start the drive. Long ball is pulled in. Fred Trevelyan takes it to the house. What a start on the drive for the Aztecs. A 76-yard score. John Barron with the extra point. 7-3 Aztecs with 8:20 to go in the first.
It's just the power of the play action. Watch what the play action does to the safety. Okeke, watching. He's right there at the top, and all of a sudden, Fred Trevelyan, a guy who caught 4 catches, 189 yards, and 2 touchdowns last week. That's how he gets behind that secondary. It's looking, I call it poor eye discipline, looking into the backfield, not understanding the guy across from you's ability. And Fred Trevelyan showed you just what he did last week in his 2 touchdowns at Fresno State. And he does it again, this time for the big one. Outstanding throw by Christian Chapman as well.
Rocky Long also made the point during the week. Chapman's a guy who doesn't get enough credit for what he's done while he's been here. The winningest 3-year stretch in program history. You know, it's funny, that ball's incomplete out to the edge from McDonald. Is Rocky Long got asked about that kind of a game earlier this week, and he said that's the type of game, not surprisingly, if you follow Aztecs football, he's not a huge fan of, because he likes a lot more of a tougher style of game, a running game. And as many have lamented, the rules changes in football at several levels have gone to favor the offense.
But what would you expect from a defensive-minded head coach? He doesn't want to see all that kind of scoring. That's one of those games that after the game is over, when you look at the stat sheet, you just rip it up.
To the edge again and incomplete. Well, you played linebacker, but you like that kind of a game?
Well, look, I like any game when you have 3 defensive scores. You had 2 interception returns for touchdowns. You had a fumble recovery for a touchdown. You had sacks. You had outstanding plays. And to me, that's what I like. Look, there's going to be points scored in today's football, whether it's college, whether it's the NFL. You're going to score points. It's about making stops. And I think that's also the model today for San Diego State, especially here on third down. It's about getting off the field and making stops.
Well, Hawaii scores with the best of them, 32 points a game. 3rd and 10, the shovel pass doesn't get them what they need. Fred Holly, the third, picks up about 6 yards, but the running back is shy of the sticks. And Hawaii will punt.
It's a good job by San Diego State retreating and then finding a way to get to the ball carrier. That's one of those shovel screens where you get everybody to get up the field and then everybody's trying to find out where's the ball carrier. By that time, Andrew Alecki stayed home, one of those Hawaii natives playing against the hometown school.
San Diego State up 7-3 on a huge throw from Chapman to Trevelyan. Last week had the most receiving yards by an Aztec since 2009. Took this one to the house. Aztec Village, a happening place to be before the game. If you had time, would you have gone on the rides out there?
No, I'm not. I saw a Ferris wheel over there, and I'm sorry, Mike. I had work to do today, and I don't want to be giving up my lunch anytime soon. I want to make sure I'm here for this ball game. As San Diego State right now offensively had the big play, but now it's what do you do outside of that big play, the passing touchdown to Trevilian, but they have to establish the run game if they want this offense to be effective.
They've been under 100 yards on the ground each of the last 2 weeks. The run game, a staple of the success of this program, going to the air for Trevilian again. Echoes incomplete. Chapman's completion to Trevilian went for 76 yards, that touchdown. And McDonald on the other side, Hawaii's quarterback, did his first four passes for 79 yards.
Yeah, both these quarterbacks right now, nice little rhythm. But if you're looking at Hawaii's defense, number one thing I'm going to look at is doubling Fred Trevilian. That's what I'm going to keep both eyes on. I'm going to keep a safety in a corner, and I'm going to force Christian Chapman, the San Diego State quarterback, I'm going to force him to throw to someone else besides number seven.
Jasmine slips one tackle, can't get through another as they try and regain some of that yardage lost on the holding penalty. Third down, a draw is about all they've got, so Jasmine, the sophomore, ends the drive. But he's been a big part of the team this year as well, with Washington having to miss time with a broken clavicle. And Rocky Long has said, hey, we might be 7-4. We lost the opportunity to play for the league title, but all in all, it's been a good year.
It's been a good year. He's had his work cut out for him, losing some key guys on offense and defense.
From inside the 25, the ball comes loose, and the Aztecs recover. Great field position for San Diego State. Special teams play. Dwayne Johnson Jr. comes up with the loose ball. And now San Diego State can add to its four-point lead.
It's all about special teams. We never talk about enough of what special teams can do, how it can flip a game. And this time, it's just getting down there and finding and putting
really
the hat,
on the field,
putting the helmet
is the
on the football.
Have possession of the
it's
ball.
A good job by San
Fumbled
Diego State.
The ball. It was recovered by the kicking team. First down.
Trenton Thompson coming in to deliver the hit that forced the ball loose.
And Thompson's just going in there doing his job. You run. In a nice form tackle, but the helmet hit the football, and that ball squirts in the air. And that's another turnover for the Aztecs defensively. This is what they want. They want to get the ball going. They want to get the ball back to their offense. And it's a great opportunity. Special teams delivering so far for the Aztecs.
Dwayne Johnson Jr., by the way, no relation to The Rock.
Glad you clarified that. Thanks, Mike.
I know some people were wondering. It is. Fortunately, Mike May and his staff here at San Diego State do a great job. Put that in the notes for us. A burst through the middle, a touchdown for Juwan Washington. And the lead is 10 for the Aztecs. Now, the previous play got them 68 yards on the punt and fumble, and it took them just one more to make it a 10-point contest.
And this is what they've been missing throughout the season. Because, like you mentioned earlier, Juwan Washington has been hurt. But watch the patience. You see how he just never committed to going all to the outside. He waits, lets the blocks develop, cuts it all the way back, and scoots his way into the end zone for a touchdown.
It's 14-3.
Just putting the hat on the ball. Create opportunities for your offense. And you get down near the goal line, got to cash in. San Diego State.
14-3, San Diego State has had two touchdown drives, each consisting of one play. So quick strike offense for the Aztecs as John Barron gets ready to kick it away with Elijah Dale set to receive for Hawaii. They'll take this out to the 25.
It's a new college football day and age now. It's about scoring points.
If you're a defense in the Big 12, it's considered a good day.
Yeah. You did remind me that the defense in the Big 12 definitely subpar. But I think a lot of people are looking at these scores and trying to figure out how is this happening. Well, look, you got a lot bigger rosters in college football. And so the NFL can't adapt to this because the numbers just aren't there. And that's why you see this many guys and this many plays and this many touchdowns, more guys in college football.
What was really wild about the Michigan-Ohio State game was that the Wolverines have been giving up just 14 points a game. And then to get 60 dropped on them was a major shock. McDonald has been looking off to his left quite a bit, finds Cedric Bird, the junior from L.A., who played his first two seasons at Long Beach City College. Cole first down.
Cole McDaniel has to kind of get into a rhythm a little bit more. We saw it in the first drive. He completed his first couple passes, but look, you know about the turnover on special teams. Now this drive has to be a point scoring drive for Hawaii to get right back on track like we saw them in the first couple drives of the game.
The Aztecs bring pressure, and they've got it figured out perfectly. Marcus Armstrong Brown takes it in before he goes out of bounds.
I love the way he spreads the wealth, though. Doesn't he? He spreads it to everybody. It's been Sharks, it's been Brooks, it's been Brown, it's been Ursula, it's been Bird. I mean, if you're a wide receiver on this Hawaii offense, Cole McDonald's going to find you. You just got to turn around and be ready when that ball comes hit your hands.
For those not using the abacus as you were listing off the names, that's six different receivers so far hit by McDonald. San Diego State forces its way into the backfield, takes down the freshman Miles Reed. Nick Rolovich now in year number three as the head coach, the 39-year-old. He was sick this week, and we mean really sick. We talked to him on the phone in the middle of the week, and he said, guys, you know what? I'm feeling a little bit under the weather. Found out he coached from the stands this week, using a megaphone to coach his team so that nobody else would get sick.
I had a chance to visit with him right before the game, and I asked him, I said, coach, am I able to talk to you now? Are you been quarantined? What's going on? He says, no, I'm feeling a lot better. He said, I'll feel a lot better after this game if we get a W.
Third and short. Nice spinning grab by Bird. First down, Hawaii.
Unbelievable catch by Bird, but I'm going to go with the throw from the quarterback. He gets it right over that level, right over the linebacker level, and Bird able to adjust his body all the way around. That was a terrific catch, but I thought the throw is really what did it for me. When you watch McDonald, he's got that nice, crisp throw, nice little touch that allowed Bird to go grab it out of the air.
A certain ornithological piece to that first down with Bird making the catch. Bird's the word. As Hawaii drives, looking to get closer, down 14-3. Pocket holds, and so do the strong hands of the junior JoJo Ward.
And this is what I'm used to seeing from Cole McDonald. He struggled last week versus UNLV. We watched it. He had two interceptions thrown, and Coach Rolovich had to pull him to the side, put him on the bench, and for the freshman, Chevin Cordero. But this is what Cole McDonald has shown me throughout the year. It's this kind of rhythm passing. When he has the time, he sets his feet, he's throwing football that only his guys can grab, keeping him out of the way of the defense.
Throw is batted away. Nice coverage on the outside by Luke Barku, the junior corner, knocking it away from JoJo Ward and preventing a touchdown.
Well, see it and go get it. You got to see it and go get it. That's what Barku did there. He read the slant. He knew the slant was coming. He came in there, reached in there with that left arm, and batted that pass away. And that's one thing that McDonald, you get down here, you don't have a lot of time, but you got to try to find a way to look some of these defensive backs off to create a nice little window to throw to.
11th play of the drive. Hand off Reed. And he tumbles backwards for a loss to the 15-yard line. The former Aztecs swarm, led by Kiava Tuzino, helping to create the pressure.
You know, if there's a big play on defense, 44 is going to be somewhere near. That's Tuzino again, making plays as always.
Chapman going long to Trevilian for 76. Two short touchdown drives. The Aztecs in control after one. Start of the second quarter. We welcome you back to ESPN College Football presented by Dr. Pepper. Third and goal, Hawaii. Last play to end the first quarter was a loss on a run. Expect them to go back to the air here. Aztecs pounce at the line. Pressure comes, throw across the middle, and there's a flag with contact. Ursua turning around and looking for the hanky as he got twisted all sorts of ways going to the back of the end zone.
Yeah, they're going to get Terry Thompson, 14.
Defense, number 14. Foul occurred in the end zone. Ball is placed at the 2-yard line. Automatic first down.
It was a nice route combination. That's the first guy I look for. Is John Ursula. He was in the slot right here, number 5. So watch how he manipulates Thompson. He goes up as if he's going to go to the outside, and watch when he puts that right foot in the ground, and all Thompson can do was just hold him. A nice route by Ursula, one of the more polished route runners in all of college football. That time had Tariq Thompson skating around back there. Commits the penalty. No touchdown.
McDonald throws over the shoulder for Elijah Dale. What a spiral to the junior running back for Hawaii's first touchdown of the night.
Gotta love the play call there. It's been wide receiver heavy the last couple plays. This time they find a matchup that they really like. It's Elijah Dale, the running back, leaking to the outside. He had man-to-man coverage with the linebacker. If I'm Cole McDonald, I'm taking that same exact route and throwing the football there. Touchdown, Hawaii.
This is a big game for these two teams tonight, trying to get to their eighth win of the season. San Diego State 7-4, want to improve their resume for bowl committees. These are two of seven bowl eligible teams in the Mountain West for five contractually obligated spots. Wyoming joining the party today as well with a win over New Mexico. Washington across the 30. So this Parker Houston, the tight end, settles into the backfield as the handoff goes to Washington, who churns his legs to the 36-yard line for a gain of 6 on first down.
Well, when you look at the San Diego State drive chart, just remember, like, big plays have really helped them. It's been the long touchdown play, 1 yard, I mean, one play, 76-yard to Fred Trevilian, and then it was the 5-yard run by Juwan Washington. But outside of that, they have not driven the football down the field. So they've had big plays that have helped them, but this is where they have to settle in and try to find a way to create a drive and not have to worry about the big play to score.
Those two scoring drives, a collective 18 seconds between them. Chapman thinking about the deep ball, instead floats it to the sideline for Kahale Waring, the tight end, who's the third leading receiver on this squad for the second straight season. And now into the second quarter, not to start this drive, no quarterback change, but it's the time of the game where we anticipate somewhere within this 15-minute window to see the redshirt junior Ryan Agnew come in at quarterback as well.
You mentioned that Chapman's still in the game, and for right now, you want to know how much longer will he be in the game, or look, is he just going to take the way that this offense has responded for the first half, put up a couple early scores, you leave Chapman in, and if he struggles, then go to Agnew.
Chapman's on the rollout. A dart of a throw is nearly taken away. Corey Bethley interrupting the pass, and so it's second and 10.
Yeah, Corey Bethley, the true freshman, guy making the play early on. He wasn't on our depth chart early. We got the call that the true freshman was going to come out there and really have a bigger role within this defense now. They've made some changes in that secondary, and Bethley is a guy who's been playing well. They move him up. Different secondary for Hawaii.
On the toss, first down and more for San Diego State. Nice pickup, getting it to the outside for Jordan Bird.
You remember that play, Mike? That was the old play that we saw San Diego State run against Boise State. And when Jordan Bird comes into the game, that's the play that he usually runs. It's an end around. He lines up on one side of the offense. He motions a circle motion around, and then all of a sudden he gets the football. And it's pretty much a guy who's got open space, pick your lane and go through. That's been an outstanding play for San Diego State all season long.
Washington with a gap. Crumples at the 5-yard line. The offensive line has looked sharp, creating space for Washington on this drive. But throughout the course of the year, what has been the key to their struggles?
Well, it's been obviously the injuries to fullback. And you had injuries to Woolsey, and that time you see number 34, Isaac Lassard, out there in front. And look, rarities in college football, yes, San Diego State still uses a fullback, but that's what's helped out the running game. And they've been banged up at that position this year. Maybe today is a game that they can get back on track with that.
run on second down. But the first down run has been friendly to them on this drive. 7 yards, 8, 9, and 8 for the Aztecs, getting back to what they do best, which play calling wise they've gotten away from over the last four games, averaging 11 more pass attempts than they did versus the first seven games and 7 fewer rushing attempts.
Well, they've played against some offenses that have taken chances, that have thrown the ball down the field, that have scored points. And when you have to score points, San Diego State, they don't want to throw the ball that many times, but they've had to because of the team that they face. They want to run it and shorten the game up.
Washington takes it, a legion of black and red in front of him. He's cut off, angled out at the boundary.
I want to see if this one is short of the line to gain. Right now it looks like it's going to be fourth down for San Diego State. I think Rocky Long, he's going to go for it. I don't see the kicker, John Barron, who's one of the seniors on this football team, running out there. It's a big down right here, fourth down for Hawaii as they bring in their substitutes.
They brought Jordan Bird in, the running back, who took the big toss earlier on this drive. So he's split out wide left with Juwan Washington in the backfield.
Key 15 at the top of the screen, number 15, Jordan Bird, like you mentioned.
There he goes. Play breaks down and Chapman has to duck his shoulders and he comes up short on fourth down.
Execution. And when you try to do something different than you're normally doing, that execution sometimes just not there. Jordan Bird in the game, they mess up the handoff, they miss everything. But if Hawaii, you get off the field on fourth down, huge play, keeping the Aztecs off the board.
They've played hot football as of late. Fred Holly, appropriately named for the holiday season, sophomore from California with the carry on first down.
A huge play defensively by Hawaii. Now, how do you back it up? Because you are backed up into your own shadows of your end zone. So what do? You got to find a way to get a first down here. That's what this drive starts has to be. Find a way to get a first down. Get a little bit of breathing room. Get you a little bit of space.
McDonald's got a clean pocket. His throw across the middle hits Bird, sprinting toward midfield and upended at the knees as he flies to the 43.
When you've got time to throw the football, you can stand in there and deliver a strike. That's where it starts at. Watch the protection up front for Cole McDonald. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000. He's able to go and allow the route to develop, and he delivers a strike to Bird on that nice little in cut. It's a nice little job there by McDonald, but the offensive line, that's where it started at. The nice protection up front.
Showing just how dangerous they can be through the air. McDonald's already got 187 yards. And looking for more. He shoveled into traffic for Reed, who had a couple linemen in front of him. So the gain's just one.
Yeah, J.R. Hensley was that offensive lineman in front of him. The play would have worked, which when you got a guy not out in front, and that's one of those plays that you got to remember, the ball has to be thrown, too, before these offensive linemen can get all the way down. But a terrific job by San Diego State, especially being right there, Troy Cassidy, the linebacker. Retreating. You get up the field, you see that, you got to retreat. Good job by Cassidy coming back and making the play.
A shoulder shimmy and a lob over the top of the defense. McDonald with the connection inside the 10 for JoJo Ward.
Wow, double moves. Double moves get you every single time. That time it was Luke Barkley, 16. And he bit on the shoulder move. Outstanding job by shoulder manipulation like you saw, Mike. You said it. You saw the shoulder by Cole McDonald, and it got Barkley just a look, just a little bit. And that time that ball got deep down there. JoJo Ward, a big, big play. But an outstanding throw as well by McDonald. Again, loving this drive. This drive started all the way back in the shadows of their own end zone.
They got space, and he has 6. You nailed it.
Keep the ball in the quarterback's hands. He went up there. He wanted to go under center. He didn't do it, but it was a read option. Fake to the running back and goes right in. He ran right through Anthony Luke. That's a big boy run by Cole McDonald, all 6'4", 205. That was a big boy run, and what an answer. San Diego State goes up 14-3, and that's now 14 unanswered points. Well, 13 late on this point after attempt. Now 14, Mike. Unanswered points by Hawaii.
13th best passing team in the country came to play today. Can you believe they came here to San Diego as a 2.5 touchdown dog? They're putting up points like it's nobody's business. The Rainbow Warriors lead it by 3.
To see what happens for them.
Utah State just scored as well as they play in Boise for the division championship. Winner goes to the Mountain West title game. So it's a 3-point game. Aggies and Broncos, same here in San Diego. Kirk Morrison, you're an Aztecs Hall of Famer. Mission Valley could look a little bit different come a couple years from now.
Well, thanks to Measure G on Election Day, that dream of a San Diego State football stadium is now coming to life. Outstanding job a couple weeks ago, the city of San Diego voting on Measure G.
This, of course, the former home of the Chargers and the Padres at one point as well. Went from San Diego Stadium to Jack Murphy Stadium to Qualcomm Stadium and now SDCCU Stadium. And that was one thing that Rocky Long was quite exuberant about, is the prospect of getting a new stadium and other schools not being able to say, hey, they're not going to have a stadium to play in.
Yeah, Rocky the other day talking to us, he sounded excited. He was excited to have this burden kind of behind him because he wanted a new stadium for some of the players and recruits to be able to come in and have a place to play.
Bird makes the catch out of the backfield, and his collision with Shanatoa, the linebacker, stops his progress at the 37-yard line. Not to mention, with the bountiful applications to this university as well, that it will expand campus quite a bit.
Well, when you have 100,000 in applicants each and every year for the university, you have to expand. There's no more room over on Montezuma Mesa. This is a site where they're going to build a stadium as well as expand campus.
There goes Bird again. And on 3rd and 3, he's still short of the first down. And as we've seen, I mean, you know, but I've been in town since Thursday. This is just about 15 minutes from everywhere, an extremely convenient location.
This is prime real estate. This is a prime place to be at Mission Valley and for the city to understand and realize how important this is for not just San Diego State football, but this is more for the city of San Diego and San Diego State University. So a job well done to the city for voting for Measure G.
JoJo Ward, fair catch at the 21.
Over to JoJo Ward. Nice little double move on the outside. The one-handed catch by John Ursua. And then doing all the work, making throws. This time, call your own number, Cole McDonald, for the touchdown.
Hawaii's offense tonight has been power to the people. 9 different receivers have caught a pass from Cole McDonald. He's off to a great start. All sorts of time, escapes a tackle, and throws to a sliding Marcus Armstrong Brown.
Now, you mentioned it, he had time, a lot of time today to throw that football. It's just about finding the windows. And this is one of the things that I think is kind of underrated in this game. He's able to find the throws that on the run that are very accurate. Now, that one was one that he probably could have thrown a little bit higher, but to get out of the pocket and see and keep his eyes downfield, that's a huge play to start the drive.
21 yards for Marcus Armstrong Brown. The guy with 3 names now has 4 catches on the night. Loading up, chucking into single coverage as the ball comes down. That pass is caught by Ward. What a grab over his shoulder as gravity did the rest for Cole McDonald.
Well, first they went at 16, Luke Barkley on the drive before this. Now they go after Ron Smith, number 17 for San Diego State. And they think they've got a matchup on the outside. JoJo Ward, at only 5'9", 175, able to adjust to that football. Dare I say a little Willie Mays-esque in center field, right field. I mean, he went all the way to the outside and adjusted his body. A terrific catch with an amazing throw again by Colt McDonald.
They went for 44. They dial up run to get about 1. Well, had he caught the ball at the other end of the field,
yes,
it would have been a more appropriate reference to say center field. He was probably at like shallow left field,
shallow
behind
left,
third
yeah.
base on the grass, ready to catch that ball.
Yeah, the former home of the Padre that you're referencing to. Look, I had to play here at San Diego State when they still had the dirt, so I was always root for the Padres to not make the postseason, to get that dirt off the field. But
well, your wish came true quite a bit.
Yeah, quickly as Petco Park was built. But so far, Cole McDonald likes what he sees on the outside.
Looks left, throws left, and it's through the hands of Ursúa. Rare that that can ever be said. But he drops it there, third and nine.
We call that alligator arms. Because that time, Ursúa was right there, and he would have got a face full of Troy Cassidy, the linebacker, 42, for San Diego State. That time, that pass was right in harm's way, but I want to see how do they handle this third down. Okay, Cole McDonald's done a great job of going through his progressions, but I get down here, I'm looking for number five, John Ursúa. He's been my go-to guy when I need it, my guy to have it. I'm looking for number five right there in the slot.
Five-man rush from SDSU. Across the middle, a leaping catch by Bird is a touchdown for Hawaii. Number 13, Cole McDonald ziplines it from 13 yards out. And the Rainbow Warriors can make their lead 10. Boy, the Aztecs jumped out to the big advantage early. First half looked pretty for the Aztecs, who have dominated this series as of late, winning six straight against Hawaii, but the Rainbow Warriors threaten to upend that streak as they lead at the break by 10. Back to San Diego, 24-14, 21 unanswered for the Rainbow Warriors of Hawaii, looking to finish off the year at 8-5 and give themselves a guarantee at a winning record. Be a nice way to finish it off. Last time they did it was 2010 when they went 10-4. Since then, they've had six losing seasons, a 500 finish. So they started the scoring in the first half with a field goal. They finished it with 21 unanswered. And now after electing to kick it away to start the game, they get the ball to start the third quarter. 326 yards through the air to go along with two touchdowns for Cole McDonald, the quarterback for Hawaii. How do the Aztecs try and slow that passing attack?
Well, I think the one thing is you got to stay on top. And right now it's with the deep passes that Cole McDonald is executing, whether it's to Bird, whether it's to, you know, obviously, or Ursúa. It's been guys getting downfield on his Aztec defense. And now, what about the San Diego State side? Will we see Christian Chapman still at quarterback, or will they make the change? Will they make the move to Ryan Agnew? Chapman struggled at the end of that half after a couple big drives, but other than that, San Diego State has to figure it out.
It was a little bit surprising to see first down pass incomplete to JoJo Ward, but a couple big catches down the stretch in the second quarter, that there wasn't the switch at quarterback for San Diego State, which is what has been the case the last couple of weeks. But you mentioned with Chapman off to a good start, perhaps they felt they'd go in a different direction, but the question mark still lingers overhead for when the Aztecs retake the field on offense. Aztecs swarm, stop Fred Holly, make it third and very long. This is the type of defensive stand they need, coupled with the penalty as well, but to be able to stem the tide a bit from Hawaii.
You need a lift, you need emotion. And right now, this game is gonna be put on the shoulders of the Aztec defense. They gotta make some stops. They got to get the ball back to their offense like they did earlier in the game, whether it's a penalty, whether it's a turnover, special teams can help out. But this Aztec defense is going to have to stand tall in the second half to create some short fields for their offense that have struggled outside of the big play.
Four-man rush, all sorts of time. Ursúa pursued quite diligently by Ronley Lakalaka, the native of Honolulu, one of four Hawaii natives on the roster for SDSU, whose brother Stephen played running back at Hawaii.
Yeah, he's one of those seniors that are playing his last game at SDCCU Stadium, and a nice job by the Aztec defense getting off the field. That's what we call a shutdown drive coming out of the halftime break.
The defense's first three and out of the night, and they'll start with favorable field position near midfield as well. Start the drive with a pass to Waring, the tight end. Makes the catch for a first down. Chapman in the first half, 4 of 9 for 99 yards. So with his fifth completion, he goes over 100 yards on the day.
Yeah, it's going to be Waring and it's going to be Trevilian. Those are the two guys offensively for San Diego State that Christian Chapman likes the most. So if I'm Hawaii, I'm making sure that I keep those guys in my sights and try to force Chapman to throw elsewhere.
Washington just a couple as he's grabbed behind on the waist from Derek Thomas.
I'm still surprised that we haven't seen Chapman take more shots down the field. We saw earlier in the game the big touchdown to Trevilian, where it's a design, we're going to go up top, we're going to try to get behind the defense of Hawaii and make them pay. We haven't seen San Diego State go back to that. I think they have to take those type of shots to create just a little bit of flexibility in that Hawaii defense, because right now they're just going to stack the box and stop the run.
Tim Wilson, who missed last week with a rib injury, grabs his 19th catch of the season. And as you mentioned, with taking those deep shots downfield, it's worth it to test the Rainbow Warriors defense in the air and on the ground. They're 106th against the run out of 130 teams and 74th against the pass. So there's plenty of opportunity no matter how you split it.
Yeah, this isn't one of the better defenses in college football, but tonight they're playing well. Outside of the big plays early in the game, they've really settled in and they've been able to get the SDSU offense off the field.
Birds in motion. You know when you see him on the field, the ball's coming his way. And he's limited to a short pickup by Shenatoa, the linebacker.
When 15's in the game, he's not there to take pictures. He comes into the game for a reason. Jordan Burns, the true freshman from Albuquerque, he comes in the game, going to get the football. And I think Hawaii knows that. They know that, hey, wherever 15 goes, alert a gadget, alert some type of play, that they're getting him the football. They've been on it outside of the initial run that he had to start the game. They've really been aware of when Bird's in the game.
Chapman goes to his first look. It's through Waring's hands. And Chapman, fortunate there wasn't a Rainbow Warrior defender there to grab it, because that was an easy one up for a takeaway.
That's a bad pass. That's a bad pass. He's wide open. Watch the quarterback. You got to hit him. Right now, he's wide open. That ball's too high. Right there, it has to be numbers. Right there, belt high, numbers. You got to put that on your tight end. He's wide open. That's one of the inconsistent things that Chapman has struggled with throughout his career at San Diego State. You need a throw, and that time, that one sails high.
Yet to convert a third down. Wanted Waring, looks the other way. High ball off Trevilian's hands, and incomplete. Well, Kirk, you said a couple times tonight it's been a bad pass. Makes you wonder if clock starts ticking on Chapman here in the third quarter.
Yeah, because right now you want to have a seat at the bowl table. And that's what this game's all about. With only five bowls eligible for the San Diego, for the Mountain West Conference, with seven bowl eligible teams, where does that put San Diego State if they lose this football game? But you got a senior kicker and John Barron, one of the options for San Diego State here.
Fourth best field goal percentage among active kickers. This try from 51 for Barron. High archer is good for the senior from Temecula.
When you got a weapon like Barron, you got to use him. San Diego State on the board in the second half.
Here at San Diego, all the young kids grow up wanting to be one day Kirk Morrison. Mike Cousins, along with the former San Diego State linebacker, a two-time All-American, and former Mountain West Conference Defensive Player of the Year. Glad to have you along with us. Late here on a Saturday night, college football's final regular season weekend of the 2018 campaign. When you're back here, Kirk, what's your favorite part about being home, if you will?
I just remember running out of that tunnel over there as an Aztec. Many battles on this field, a lot of fun with my team, a lot of fun times with my teammates. But it's a special place to play. And
you know what'll be interesting to see too is what happens with the group of five, with UCF's Mackenzie Milton going down with a knee injury, it's Armstrong Brown with the catch and a pickup of about five, and how that relates to the Mountain West, because behind UCF you have Utah State and Boise State ranked 21st and 23rd respectively. Those two teams separated by 3 points right now over on ESPN. I think that this coming Tuesday, not a whole lot will change for UCF because they still picked up the win despite the loss of Milton. So the committee says, well, hey, we don't want to project anything going forward. Incomplete, nearly intercepted. Second time tonight, Tariq Thompson nearly has taken one away. However, for UCF, if they don't look great in the American Conference Championship game next weekend, that could flip things for them.
Yeah, it could open the door for one of these Mountain West schools, like you mentioned, Utah State or Boise State, to possibly represent the group of five. Look, if we're looking at UCF the same without Mackenzie Milton, I would think that we're wrong for that. He's been a, to me, not just a group of fivesmen that we call, which is the best player in the group of five. He's one of the best players in college football, so definitely something to look at.
Going deep for Ursua. He wanted to come back on that ball, was looking for a flag, and doesn't get it. Coverage from Parker Baldwin.
Yeah, that ball's underthrown. And when it's underthrown, that's why the penalty was not, the flag was not thrown on that play. Parker Baldwin was in great position. Ball hits him in the back. That ball's just underthrown. If McDonald's able to get that ball out in front, we're possibly talking about a big play that would have set them up inside the San Diego State red zone.
Baldwin, who had the coverage there, one of the 14 San Diego State seniors in action tonight, playing in his 53rd game, never missed a kickoff in his career. That's a way to do it. Second straight three and out, forced by San Diego State, a 7-point game. Finally converted a third down, 1 for 8 today. Trevilian, who caught the big touchdown in the first quarter, takes that for a first down. And to finish up the note on Chapman and Agnew, the quarterbacks, the expectation today was that the plan would be the same as it was the last two games, that Agnew would come in for a couple series in the second quarter. Coaches would huddle, decide who would start the second half. And yet today, as you mentioned, senior day, it's been all Christian Chapman.
I mean, the ball's on the 42-yard line, and he's well behind the football on the 25-yard line, is Agnew.
Washington, the lead back, injured earlier this year, back to action, gets to the line of scrimmage and no further.
You got to win first down. And that's one thing that, one of the reasons why the offense has struggled throughout this season, is because instead of 2nd and 3, 2nd and 4 for San Diego State, it's been 2nd and 9, 2nd and 8. On this instance now, it's 2nd and 10. It's hard to make up that kind of yards with only on 2nd down and 3rd down. It's been putting San Diego State behind the chains, forcing Chapman to have to make some throws to get this team to move the chains.
Quick drop and an off-balance throw over the head of his tight end, Ware. It's been a good showing today from the Hawaii defense, allowing a total of 260 yards for San Diego State. So Hawaii defense without its leading tackler, Jelani Tavai, who's out for the year. He's been out for the last month after hurting his right shoulder against Nevada on October 20th. But they closed out strong last week. That come-from-behind effort against UNLV helped them to just 121 yards in the second half. Now they need a stop on third and 10. They drop seven. Chapman wants to run for it. A flag is down, and he's brought down 4 yards shy of the first down marker by Pine Pavihi, the linebacker.
Big 77, Ryan Pope again with a hold right around the line of scrimmage, holding on number 77, Pope. Had a nice big chunk of that jersey.
Holding, offense, number 77, 10 yards from the previous spot. It's third down.
Here's Pope here, the left tackle, and just watch as the play develops. Everything's okay, everything's going good, and then when Chapman tries to escape the pocket, he just watch the left hand. They're going to call that every single time. That hand's on the outside.
You're a little puzzled that Hawaii didn't decline that and just let it be fourth down?
No, because Rocky Long is going to go for it. I mean, that's the situation that he makes. I like to push him back a little bit. Because what does San Diego State show me on third down? Can they convert this down to distance? This is something that they struggled at. Third and 20, there's not a lot of plays in the book. In my playbook, for sure, on third and 20, especially the way the quarterback
struggled. This is the end of the third quarter.
15 minutes to go. Put the fours up in the air. Hawaii by a touchdown over San Diego State. The start of the fourth quarter. Hawaii Rainbow Warriors making the long trip over from home, up 24-17.
Maybe just one.
One of the attributes for Agnew that separates him from Chapman is the ability to run.
The ability to do just that, like you mentioned. This is what he brings to the offense. You talk about a spark. He looks, and that's just a QB design run. I mean, he doesn't even look at his first option. He's taken off the whole time, and now that's another element that now Hawaii's defense, they have to take into account. This may be a much different offense with Agnew that they're not accustomed to seeing with what Chapman was doing in the first half.
Third in motion, Washington takes the flip off to the left side, and he could have been gone. Tripped up along the sideline, might have been the equalizer, but Corey Bethley got a hand on his shoelace and stopped the play.
Man, just watch the play. It's all student body left. You know, everybody's all out front, and Juwan Washington, they wanted more of this. I mean, this is the guy who they expected to be, you know, in a long lineage of running backs from DJ Pumphrey to the first round pick of the Seahawks last year, Rashad Penny. Juwan Washington, they expected him to be that, but the injury slowed him down. He's got great ability. We saw it on that last run.
There he goes, about 9 yards on the carry for Washington, his 21st of the night, and just shy of 100 yards tonight. So he's over 800 now for the season on the ground.
It's only been 4 plays that Agnew's been in, but clearly this Aztec offense looks totally different. It looks like they got more life, like they got more juice, and that's what Agnew brings into the game. I think that's the magic in which Rocky Long is hoping for in this final stretch in this fourth quarter.
I think the only surprise, Kirk, was how long they waited to bring him in.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Off the fake, he throws, tipped away. Wearing the target would have set him up first and goal.
Watch Caitlin Hicks, the junior. Patience, patience, and not panicking at the point of attack. Just gets a hand in there, and actually he gets the left elbow of Weary and knocks the elbow backwards, and Weary couldn't corral the football in.
Third and short, first down from Juwan Washington. Mention the injuries that have plagued San Diego State this year along the offensive line, at fullback, at running back, and especially at quarterback. But Agnew, a great year for him, starting 7 times and leading them to 6 wins in those 7 starts.
Yeah, 9 touchdowns, 5 interceptions on the year. But I think the big game, which was the one at Boise State, he brought his team in there, and they were just better than the Boise State Broncos that day. It's one of the big wins on his resume.
immediate pressure after he faked the handoff, pursued toward the sideline. The short check down for Waring, and he steps his way to the 14.
Just doing your job is sometimes what you never know when it's going to be a big play. Zeno Choi chasing Agnew down, but this is the ability that he has to create and make something out of nothing. There's nothing there. Choi coming down, bearing down on Agnew, and he gets all the way to the outside and just flicks a little pass over to the tight end and picks up positive yardage. A second and two, much different than what we saw earlier, the second and eights and second and nines.
Loaded up here with multiple tight ends. Washington shimmies his way inside the 15-yard line, still short, but it's been a nice night for him. It started slow. His fourth 100-yard rushing game of the season and the first 100-yard rushing game for the Aztecs since they played Arizona State back in September, the 15th of September.
Yeah, that was the third game of the season. It's been a long time. You go from September and we're already past Thanksgiving to get a 100-yard rusher.
Hawaii coming up with a big push on third down, led by Pene Pavihi, the linebacker. Rainbow Warriors by seven. They scored 21 unanswered. After going up 3-0, it was 14-3. San Diego State getting a long field goal from John Barron, and Rocky Long stoic on fourth and one as they go for it inside the 15. He's on the run. He floats it. It's caught by Isaac Lassard, who's into the end zone. Touchdown, San Diego State.
It was either going to be downhill run or get Ryan Agnew on the move, the run pass option. And that one's an easy one. He has his tight end wide open. Isaac Lassard on the outside. He just flicked the wrist. That's a touchdown. Yeah. That was a close call, but it's a touchdown. And it's Ryan Agnew. He's the reason for it. I mean, you change the quarterbacks, and all he does is come in and in his first drive lead the Aztecs on a touchdown drive. I said it. He's the spark that Rocky Long was looking for. That's why they went to Ryan Agnew.
Got it, and we're even at 24. The Aztecs have scored all 10 points put on the board in the second half, pitching a shutout so far after they were down 24-14 at the break and have come back to tie. Into traffic. Nice two-handed catch from Armstrong Brown. He's thrown down across midfield. A much-needed conversion for Hawaii.
Much-needed. That was in front of four different Aztecs. You talk about threading the needle. Watch the quarterback's eyes. He looks off, and he comes back all the way across the field. And there's four Aztecs right there. And that's just a delivery of the football where his guy can go and get it. And you mentioned Armstrong Brown with a strong hand catch. You get excited about that with point, let him know, first down.
28-yard grab gives McDonald 427 yards tonight, and still plenty of ball to play. 4 yards on the ground for the freshman Reed. But for as much as John Ursua has been the primary target this year, see Reed coming off a little uncomfortable. Ursua came in fourth in receiving yards in FBS. Tonight, he's been held to just 4 catches, 34 yards for number 5 in white. But the big target has been Cedric Burt, 6 catches for a 140 for number 6. Scanning progressions. Burt, the target incomplete.
He's got all time, all day back in that pocket to sit back, set his feet, go through the progressions, but you're going to need him to continue to keep throwing the football in areas that extend the chains. Third down situation here. Look, you know you want to end this series with some sort of kick, whether it's a punt, whether it's a field goal, or a point after attempt.
Pocket strong, nearly intercepted. It's fourth and five. Wow.
You learn. That time it was Troy Cassidy, the middle linebacker, and he learned because watch. He looks and he comes all the way back. It's the movement by Cole McDonald to show one way, and Cassidy having the flip of the hips, being able to break on that football and read the quarterback's eyes. If he doesn't make that play, that's probably a first down for Hawaii.
Not the prettiest punt Guardians ever let go, but it takes a Hawaii bounce down to the 20. Just a 24-yard punt. So 3:53 to go. The Aztecs hoping this can be the game-winning drive. It starts with a run from Juwan Washington, who takes his 25th carry of the night, the workhorse for them, tackled by Kalen Hicks.
What was effective in the last drive, though, with Agnew? It was not only the running of Juwan Washington, but it was also the legs. It was the feet of Ryan Agnew being able to take off and put some pressure on the defense. We saw it on the touchdown throw to Lasard, getting out on the edges. We'll see if San Diego State tried to do the same thing. Play action here, getting the ball out on the edge.
Washington through the middle, first down. Still plenty of time to go. However, even if San Diego State doesn't get a touchdown, they have one of the best field goal kickers in college football. John Barron with a long of 54 yards this year. And going back to 1996, only one FBS kicker has ended the season perfect from 50 plus. And this year, Barron is 5 for 5 from that distance. So he could be the second.
This is 4-minute offense now, and it's playing keep away. You got 2:40 left now on the clock. You're going to just continue to run the football, eat clock, and know where the target line is. And that target line, for me, is right around the 35-yard line. I think that's where San Diego State has to get to in order to be in John Barron range, where he can kick anything from 50-plus. But I'm probably putting it right on the 35-yard line, getting that football right around there and not giving Hawaii any time on the clock.
Agnew steps up, tries to read the lanes of traffic, and gets bear-hugged into the turf by Derek Thomas. Down to 2 minutes.
Now, the critical third down here.
Jasmine's in the backfield. Washington has been the workhorse, and they go to the air on third down. Real deep. There's the flag as Wilson got held up, trucking down the sideline against Roe Ferris, the corner. There's life for the Aztecs on this drive.
Pass interference, defense, number 4, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
This is just a design shot. He was going to throw this regardless if he was open or not. And this time, Roe Ferris, like you mentioned, he's there. He's in good position. He just didn't have to turn around. If he keeps running with Wilson, that ball would have been overthrown. He was in perfect position, but that last little turn where he squared up on the wide receiver, that's where the officials called that penalty because he impeded the progress of Wilson.
Washington's back on the field, and they give it to him. No gain.
Now this just becomes a game of keep away. And the Aztecs are going to keep looking at that clock, taking that clock all the way down.
But they still got to pick up some yardage to get into field goal range.
Absolutely. But even still, they'll play for a tie. I mean, in terms of taking it to overtime. I mean, they'll take it all the way down and put it in a situation where only they will have their own chance at destiny in their own hands. They want to make it to where it's only them scoring and not allow Hawaii nothing left.
Agnew surveys. He throws behind Houston, reaching back to get it. And now we've got a rugby scrum. And it deflates at about the 42. Clock's still going, though. Down to a minute now.
Yeah, it's no rush. No panic.
They got two timeouts.
Yeah, there's still no rush. No panic. You get down. You're still right now third down. And just you let everybody know, take a deep breath, everybody. Take a deep breath. Relax. We have a senior kicker in John Barron. We have a ton of faith in him. But you got to run the ball here.
What do you say, 8 to 10 more yards to get into field goal range?
Yeah, to be a comfortable field goal. Much more comfortable than this one. This one right now is a lot longer than I think he would want it to be.
Play action. Agnew running. He's got the first down and then some. How about that for a third and one? Handoff all night. And they bring in Agnew at quarterback. He has been a fourth quarter spark.
Yeah, it's getting him on the run. You put the ball in his hands, you just let him go. Let him find a crease, find an alley. But you put him, the run pass option has been his best play. He hasn't been great at just standing in, looking, going through progressions. It's just one, you give him one opportunity to throw the football. If it's not there, take off and run. That time, he came out of the rollout, didn't see anything, and just takes off and run.
Open space, Washington first down. Stopped shy of the 15-yard line by Hudson Rasmussen. A field goal and a victory are in sight for the Aztecs.
Just getting off left tackle. Watch the block by the fullback, Lassard. He gets the edge. And Washington cuts underneath. And he gets the extra yard that he needs.
First down. Clock should have stopped with 53 seconds. There was no timeout called by either team. Thank you.
Kirk, the way this program changed when they brought John Barron on board, the senior from nearby Temecula.
Correct.
When he was signed, Rocky Long said the team wasn't even thinking about kicking field goals. Their situation was so bad, they would just go for it on fourth down. They'd go for two. He's changed the program.
Yeah, changed the program all the way around. When you have a weapon like that, and you got points in your back pocket. I mean, even earlier, Rocky Long went for a 50-plus yard field goal. That's the confidence that he's had. And when you have that guy on there, you just makes your play calling as an offensive play caller totally different, knowing you got points in your back pocket.
Now part of the expectation from the offense, if they don't score a touchdown, just get the ball where Barron likes it, whether it's left, middle, or right.
Well, I think right now, Rolovich is going to hold on to that timeout and try to ice the kicker. That's what he's going to do. So try to just disrupt the rhythm a little bit of John Barron, because they're not calling timeout. They're going to force the Aztecs to call their final timeout.
Down by 10 at the half. It's Barron for the win. His kick is no good! And we are headed to overtime in San Diego. A jaw-dropping finish to 60 minutes of football between Hawaii and San Diego State.
Just a little bit. That's why you call timeout. It looked to me that the operation was a little bit off. Like the snap was just a little bit mishandled, and that's all you need for the kick to be missed. You don't have the proper hold, bad snap, everything. You want to make sure that thing is picture perfect. Overtime in San Diego.
So McDonald, quite a game, 27 for 42, a career best 427 yards against the Aztecs. Pressured from behind, his pass incomplete in the neighborhood of Marcus Armstrong Brown.
Nothing changes for Hawaii here. Now it's just about scoring. And you would rather score a touchdown, because if it comes down to just a field goal, you do give the edge to San Diego State. Even though they just missed the field goal opportunity here, you want to get seven. You get seven, it forces now San Diego State to have to throw the ball or have to even drive a couple plays with their running game.
about that burst defensively. A hard shot from Ronley Lakalaka, the native Hawaiian, putting a pop into Reed.
Yeah, that's a big hit, but one thing about the hit is that it keeps it to a still a third and long for San Diego State defense. They get off the field here, they can force a field goal, which to me is a win. Anytime that you could force a team to kick a field goal in overtime, that's a win. That's what you can go over to your side.
He waits, he delivers to the 10-yard line. And a catch. The Aztecs, a heavy protest.
We're going to take a look at it really quickly. McDonald throws it. That ball gets down. The Aztecs up on the ground. They're protesting that ball hit the ground.
Sets up first and 10, Hawaii. McDonald's got it. End zone. Tipped and incomplete.
You got to continue to play.
I can't get past that, though. Yeah. I mean, we saw multiple looks where the ball comes to the ground. It's not in possession of the receiver. I disagree strongly with that call.
Yeah, I think the officials saw something that we didn't see, and maybe we can get an explanation a little bit later, but for right now, this is where a defense has to move on, because the call didn't go your way, and you can't allow the call by the officials to go against you again, meaning that you got to go out here and you got to stop them, hold them to a field goal. That's what the mindset should be, Aztecs on defense right now.
They don't need to score a touchdown. They can still pick up another first down if they get it inside the 1 yard line. They've got it down to the 5 here to bring up third down.
Another crucial third down again. And you held them before, or at least you thought, and the officials ruled it a first down, but this is huge for the Aztecs. Huge for the Aztecs. Have to get a stop here, force that field goal. Watch Tizino. Watch 44, the middle linebacker. Kiava Tizino, 44. He's been a menace all day. And if I'm Rocky Long, I'm sending 44 up the middle. The offensive lineman went straight up the field.
Third and 9, first possession of overtime. Hawaii wants to take the lead. Back corner floater. Touchdown, Rainbow Warriors. JoJo Ward puts him in front.
You talk about a throw. That was a throw. To have the understanding of where you're at on the field. He knew he was not going to have enough time to laser that ball in there. And he just realizes, I got to loft this up there. And it seemed like that ball took forever to come down out of the sky. But JoJo Ward at the end of the rainbow with a touchdown.
The force of 9.8 meters per second squared never felt so light as that ball came down for Ward. That's the pull of gravity, by the way.
Yeah, you went Syracuse on me, but go ahead.
Did not take any science, believe me. But McDonald did a great job stepping up there.
Yeah, he stepped up and then just threw it out there to allow his guy to go get it. You know, he just threw it to an area, and that's what you want from your quarterback. Sometimes you can't make the perfect pass to hit him right on the numbers or right in the hands.
I don't know about you. I can't help think about what might have been for the Aztecs in the second half had they gone to Agnew earlier. He provided a spark, but just a little bit more could have propelled them to a win in regulation. Now their response in overtime. Dangerous on the flip. One play. One run. Touchdown, Juwan Washington. Their third one-play touchdown drive of the night. This one at a crucial time, and they're an extra point away.
You talk about a recovery. That's a touchdown, but he bobbled it. And now you look at Rocky Long. They're going for two. They're going for the win. They don't want to go. Watch the bobble here by Juwan Washington. He bobbled the original toss from Agnew. He was able to regain it, keep his eyes upfield, cut back for a touchdown. But Rocky Long doesn't want to take this into a second overtime.
Third play, third look. They've got Washington in the backfield. A fade for the win. Incomplete. And Hawaii ends its losing streak against San Diego with a 31-30 overtime victory.
Longevity pass is incomplete. It's in for number 87, Colin Waring.
You love the call to go for it, but I'm not so sure I love that call. You throw a 50-50 fade ball to Kahale Waring. And to me, I don't know if that's the call that I go with. I like the call going for it, going for two, ending a game, but that ball's in the left hash. And what's gotten you back in the game in the second half? It's been the legs and the arm of Ryan Agnew, booting him out, reversing field, allowing him to, hey, if it's there, I can throw it. If it's not there, I can take off. And I thought on the last play, you took away his best asset, which was the use of his legs. And wow, what a way for Hawaii not only to win this game, to hold on to end the streak versus the Aztecs, and a hard one for the Aztecs at home in their last game.
31-30, the final score. And the end of the regular season. Now these teams await their bowl placement come postseason. So it ends with a fade, and Hawaii goes home happy, 31-30 winners. Thanks so much for being with us tonight. On behalf of our production crew in Charlotte, led by Tom Schofield, our broadcast partner Kirk Morrison, and I'm Mike Cousins. We send you now to an encore presentation. South Carolina and Clemson take you into the morning, wherever you might be. Good night.